Hello, I'm Alex, and in this video I'm going to show you how to create a hub in dbtvault. Let's start by assuming you already have a stage view created using dbtvault stage macro in an earlier video. This is what it should look like. It contains all of the columns that we need to populate a portion of our raw vault, including the hub we are about to create. Let's start by creating a hubs folder within our raw vault folder, just to keep things nicely organized, and create hubcustomer.sql. And whilst we're here, just for convenience, I'm going to configure the materialization in the model itself. This can be defined in multiple places in dbt, however. Okay, and let's start providing the metadata. So the first bit of metadata will be the source model. And this is the place where all the columns that are going to end up in our hub reside. So we want to get the customer PK. And the customer PK is in the staging area I showed you earlier, so V stage orders. And all the rest of the columns are going to be in there as well. Let's duplicate this a few times just to save some time. And our first core piece of metadata will be the source PK. In this case, we want to get this from a column called customer PK in VStage orders. Next bit will be the natural key or the business key. And this will be called customer key in VStage orders. Next bit is load date timestamp. In our case, this is called load date. And finally, the record source, which we've called record source in VStage orders. And there you go. So those are the four columns we need to create our hub. And now all we need to do, as we finish with the metadata, is provide the macro call for the dbtvault hub macro. This is one I made earlier. You can copy and paste this from the dbtvault documentation, you can type it out, or you can copy it from another hub you already have. So without further ado, now that the hub is ready to be loaded, all I need to do is run dbt. There you go. So let's check Snowflake and have a look at what's being created. Give it a refresh. Hub customer. This is what we expected. We've got our customer PK, customer key, load date, and record source all selected from our staging area of VStage orders. Let's have a look at VStage orders while we're here. So we've got all of our raw staging columns that we've taken directly from the source. There's our customer key, which is our business key for this hub. And then let's have a look at all the hashes and derived columns that we've generated using the dbtvault stage macro. So here's our record source, should be TPCH orders all the way down. We've got the load date, and then we've got the customer PK, which is the hash of the customer key. And that's it. Our hub has been deployed successfully. So let's go back and just generate the documentation to show you the lineage. That's been generated, so now we can do dbt.serve. And that's the dbt documentation loaded. So let's go ahead and click on the button in the bottom right here called which says view lineage graph. Click that. Now we can see the lineage of all the data flowing through to the hub customer. So this is all the TPCH sample data coming from Snowflake into raw orders, where we are combining the data ready to be fed to VStage orders, our staging macro with all the hashes and derived columns that we need to load the raw vault. And here's the first item in our raw vault, hub customer. There you go. Thank you very much, and see you in the next video. Thanks so much for watching. For more information, take a look at the dbtvault documentation, join myself and our community of users on Slack, visit the DataVault user group forums, And finally, find out about our available range of enterprise consulting and training services to get your project moving forward and delivering value fast.